Okay, I don't understand. You've been hearing a voice and you didn't think to tell me?
I didn't want to worry you.
We made a promise not to shut each other out. Just tell me what's going on.
I woke the magical spirits of the Enchanted Forest.
Okay, that's definitely not what I thought you were going to say. Wait, the Enchanted Forest? The one that Father warned us about?
Yes.
Why would you do that?
Because of the voice. I know it sounds crazy, but I believe whoever is calling me is good.
How can you say that? Look at our kingdom.
I know. It's just that my magic can feel it. I can feel it.
Okay.
Maybe it could show me where my magical powers come from. I need to follow the voice.
You are not going alone.
Anna? No. I have my powers to protect me. You don't.
Excuse me? I climbed the North Mountain, survived the frozen heart, and saved you from my ex-boyfriend. And I did it all without powers. So, you know, I'm coming.
Fine. But first, you need to equip yourself with a new skill.
What skill?
We're going into the unknown, the Enchanted Forest. We might awaken the spirits of the forest and unleash the elemental forces upon Arendelle. You're going to have to convince the spirits that people in our town are not doing anything to enrage the forest's classical elements of earth, water, fire, and air. Olaf has been gathering data on the villages. We need to analyze the data and present the results to the spirits.
You tell me when. I'm ready. I was born ready.
If you say so, Anna, you will need to learn data science to analyze the data of the villages. You can do it, Anna.
You need to show yourself. Step into your power. Throw yourself into something new.
Okay, I get it.
The first thing you need to do is to decide which programming language you want to learn.
Oh, I know. There's R and Python.
You're partly right, Anna. There are many programming languages, but R and Python are some of the easiest to learn because they contain many different packages.
What's a package, Elsa?
You can think of a package as a bundle of codes, data, and documentation that people have created to make your life easier.
Oh, so there's a chance that someone has already solved the problem that we are working on and we can simply download their package?
That's right.
So which programming language should I choose, Elsa?
Well, it doesn't matter really. What matters most as a beginner is that you prioritize getting a few projects done rather than learning the theory. But one of the main differences between R and Python is that Python is a full-fledged programming language. You can create and deploy pipelines into production or on websites using just Python alone. R, on the other hand, is more for data analysis and statistics. And R is better for data visualization where you can customize graphs easily.
I'm ready to start coding. What tools should I use?
You need an integrated development environment, or IDE for that. An IDE allows you to test and debug your code. It provides features such as code inspections, version control system, error highlighting, and more.
Got it. What are the IDEs for R and Python?
For Python, there is PyCharm and Spider. For R, there's RStudio and RStudio Cloud. The RStudio Cloud allows us to analyze our data using the RStudio IDE directly from the web browser. We can also use the Jupyter Notebook with R and Python.
Installing, and done! Now, where do I get data?
There are a few different open data sources. There's the Kaggle repository. Kaggle has a large community of users where people can contribute by solving tasks related to a dataset, submit their results, and receive or give feedback. There is also data.gov, which is the United States government's open data portal. It contains datasets from different governmental agencies. You can filter data according to location, topics, types, organizations, and more.
That is so interesting, Elsa. What if I'm interested in collecting data from websites?
That is a good point, Anna. You can try something called web scraping. It is a great skill to learn, but web scraping has been a legal gray area, so we need to make sure that the activity is fully legal and not to republish data in a way that violates copyright.
Got it, sis. Let's be safe then, sorry. So what are the tools we can use?
If you're planning to construct your data science projects using Python, then we can use Beautiful Soup for web scraping to pull data out of HTML and XML files and then analyze the data using pandas.
And if I'm using the R programming language?
If you're using R, we can use RVS or RCrawler to harvest information from websites.
Wow, cool. Then to analyze the data, we need packages, don't we?
That is right. My favorite art package is Tidyverse. Tidyverse is a collection of art packages that are designed to work together.
Oh wow, neat. What about Python packages?
There is NumPy for performing a wide variety of mathematical operations on arrays. If you work with tabular, matrix, or time series data, Pandas is your go-to package. And for visualization, there is Matplotlib and Seaborn.
Elsa, can you give me a quick demonstration of what we have learned so far? Maybe start with the Jupyter and RStudio IDEs?
No problem, let's start with Python. We can use the Jupyter IDE. We can do a demo on Seaborn, a high-level interface for plotting graphs. Let's use the iris flower dataset for this example. There are three species of iris, and we want to see how the four features, sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width, relate to each other depending on the iris species.
What codes do we need for that, Elsa?
We only need three lines of code. First, we import the Seaborn package. Then, we load the iris dataset. And finally, we plot the data using the parplot function. Easy peasy.
That is so amazing! Only three lines of code and we get such a pretty graph. Can we do the same with the R programming language?
Totally! Let's open the RStudio IDE. We only need two lines of code for R. First, we load the ggali package. Then, we plot the iris dataset using the ggpairs function. We can set the transparency to 0.5 using alpha.
Two lines of code? Even easier! What do we do next, Elsa?
Let's pick this up another time.
Aww, but I still have so many questions.
Save them for another day, Anna.
You know I don't have that kind of patience.